Hey guys, and welcome back to my channel. Today's video will be my top 13 kills from Friday the 13th. In honor of Friday the 13th, I've decided to post a video showing my favorite kills from each of the movies. I've added a bonus kill just because I love the number 13 and it's Friday the 13th, so you know, why not? Friday the 13th Part 1. Including Mrs. Voorhees, a total kill count that I tallied up for Part 1 was 10 people. Out of 10 of those kills, my favorite had to have been the slow-motion decapitation of Pamela Voorhees. Alice has been through a lot, clearly, and decided to take charge by slicing the head off of our beloved mother, who was only taking on revenge of the death of her son, Jason. I rank this as my favorite from this movie because, hey, the bitch deserved it, and the kill was just done so well. I also believe that this was one of the first decapitations that I can remember seeing as a child. Friday the 13th, Part 2. About an hour in, we get to my favorite kill from Part 2. The total of 9 kills that I tallied, the machete to the face of Mark was my favorite. It's not because he's in a wheelchair, however, him being in the wheelchair made it a little bit more enjoyable as his death couldn't get any more painful. Then they decided to roll him down a flight of stairs on top of it. I really enjoyed it because I'm sick and twisted. With a total of 12 kills in Part 3, it makes it a little bit more difficult to choose which kill were my favorite. However, there's one scene that I enjoyed the most. I thought it was really creative. With an honorable mention, I'll throw in the arrow through the eye. However, the best kill had to have been when Jason lifts Rick and squeezes his head so much that his eye pops out. The final chapter, Part 4. Although I enjoyed all 14 kills from Part 4, I have to say that the kill of Jason by Jarvis with the machete through the head was my favorite. We have the face reveal, which was super awesome, and then the machete hits, and he slowly slides down over. I just love that part, and I thought it was done so well. Next, we're going to move into Part 5, A New Beginning. I want to applaud this movie for showing all them titties. For one. Secondly, let's talk about the kills. There was a total of 22 kills in this movie, including the dream sequences. So far in order of movies, this one takes the highest kill count. I had to really think about my favorite one for the movie, and it was pretty difficult. There are a lot that I enjoyed, but I think my favorite had to be when Jason used a belt, wrapped it around the eyes of Tina's boyfriend, and of his head, and tightened it with a stick. I really thought this was a creative kill. It was effective.
Jason Lives, Part 6. I want to give this one a thumbs up. Of course, we're bringing Jason back, maggots and all. With a total of 18 kills, Jason Lives brought us a few more of those happy kills. One of my favorites from the movie would be when he is in the woods stalking the men, thus leading to Jason smashing their heads against a tree. This leaves a emoji-looking smiley face and also rips off his arm. I thought this was a comical nature. And it really added to the movie, but maybe that's just me. Oh, and did you know that most of these kills were men?
Next, we move on to Part 7, The New Blood. Hands down, my favorite kill would have to be Judy's kill. Her death was great. New Blood offers us 16 kills in total. I love how we're at the 7th film and there's still all these new ideas coming forward to kill a person. It's awesome. I really enjoyed when Jason grabbed Judy in the sleeping bag and slammed her against a tree. Looking at it now, yeah, you can tell that it was fake. However, back then, I enjoyed the movie. I thought it was great. It was quick. It was effective. Now, next, I want to talk about Part 8, Jason Takes Manhattan. We've had a pretty decent amount of kills in this movie. Deaths by mirror shards, drowning in an alley, and even Jason himself was electrocuted. One scene that I enjoyed the most had to be when Julius is having that ultimate fight on the rooftop that eventually leads to him getting his head punched off. It was awesome. I thought it was so funny and again another creative way to kill off a person. There are 20 deaths in total, including accidental shootings, an explosion, and I wanted to throw in the fact that there was a guy thrown up against a mirror at the diner. Not sure if he died, but I added it anyway. Fun fact, the guy thrown up against the mirror actually replaces Jason in Freddy vs. Jason. Isn't that neat? Now we're going to move on to Jason Goes to Hell. Jason Goes to Hell came out in 1993. Starting with Jason being blown into pieces counts as a kill and then coming back reliving in the doctor's body. Yeah. I want that hand clap for them titties too. A kill I liked most out of all 24 kills, including possessions and Jason dying twice, was Josh's body. I loved it when Josh's body melted and was mutated. I thought it was sticky and gruesome. I also enjoyed the look of Jason in this movie. The mask was great, the kills were great, and I did love the costume. Now we're going to slither on over to Jason X. Jason X didn't get a lot of love from the horror community. It's one of those movies that people would watch as a guilty pleasure, so they say. That being said, there's a scene that stands out the most of this movie from the franchise, and it's my favorite. It's something I will always remember, and this would be the freeze face scene when Jason takes Adriana's head and pushes her into liquid nitrogen and bashes her head against the counter. I loved it. Impossible in real life, maybe, but very effective on screen. Jason X ranks in with 25 total kills, one of the highest counts so far. Now we're going to move on to Freddy vs. Jason. I can't do a movie count without this movie. Jason was great, Freddy was great, but Jason stood out with 22 kills in total, including Freddy. This movie had the tits, the blood, the kills, and the comical nature. One of my favorite kills from the movie was Trey's death. Trey was pricked. He was a prick in this movie. He was brutally attacked by a machete and then folded in half in a bed. I was like, yeah, boy. I really enjoyed this part. I thought it was awesome. I also enjoyed the ravers being slashed with the flaming machete. I thought it was awesome. Definitely another favorite of mine. Friday the 13th reboot. Here's one a lot of people don't really enjoy. Hands down, my favorite kill from this movie was when Amanda was hung over the fire while camping, of course, and roasted alive. I thought this was awesome. Including Pamela, there is a total of 14 kills in this film. Not a high kill count considering most of the other movies had more. I expected more with it being a reboot and a remake, but it was still really great. I really enjoyed the movie, and the campfire thing was just awesome. And my last bonus kill for the number 13, a kill that I think has to be added to the list, as it's the revenge. This is the revenge kill that Jason got on Alice for killing his mother, who was revenge killing for the death of him. I know, it sounds retarded, but ramming the ice pick through her head 11 minutes in part 2, she deserved it, right? I thought it was awesome. Anyway, if you guys like this video, don't forget to give it a thumbs up. Tell me what you think. Leave a comment in the comment section below, and if you like what you see, don't forget to hit that subscribe button. And until next time, creep it real, and I will see you guys at my next video.